thank you very much for inviting me here in this wonderful place and giving the opportunity to speak with such distinguished people, students, and not only students. I see here some other people as well. Yeah, this is great pleasure for me, especially because of my profession in the last century. Then I was a lawyer, and I wish I entered in this school as a student now here, and probably Ms. Speaker would not mind if we entered here as classmates, being students. But yes, life brought me to this position where I am now, and then that's right, I was active in politics, in legal life, although I don't know how it feels to be called as one of the fathers, as you said, yeah?
Well, it's always
one of the fathers.
Always some legends already starting.
Yeah, of course. There are many legends, but what brought us here and why we are here, first of all? And this is delegation of Georgian Parliament, and this is my first visit in this capacity to this beautiful country and beautiful city. And we came here at this time with purpose, just 2-3 weeks before the Vilnius summit, because when we started planning our visit to Latvia and to Lithuania, where we are going after the end of this visit, we wanted to come here exactly in this period of time, because we wanted to be among friends and to discuss the case of Georgia, where we are now, how well we are prepared for success during the Vilnius summit, and to discuss already the things which we expect after Vilnius and until Riga. So this was main topic why we came here and what we discussed about. At the same time, we really wanted to tell to our friends what's going on in Georgia, because sometimes our country is surprising the world and friends as well, so with some unexpected developments, one of them being the Rose Revolution, which you mentioned, because in those days, 10 years ago, it was hardly imaginable that the new leadership could achieve the success which they achieved during a very short period of time, because Georgia then was called already as failing state or failed state, and the scholars and analytics were just discussing about that it is already failed or it is failing state, because the things were not coming together under the leadership of President Shevardnadze. And then suddenly a group of young people made a miracle, and the things were changed so rapidly that the people were surprised, what's going on in Georgia, how it is possible. Well, after that, many things happened, unfortunately, not only positive things. There were some fundamental mistakes, but by the time when we, the Georgian Dream Coalition, came together, it was difficult to believe that President Saakashvili and his team could be defeated during the elections, and whoever would defeat them would continue Georgia's journey towards Europe and NATO, because mainstream belief was that, well, if Saakashvili and his team are defeated, then that means that some other kind of people are coming, I don't know, new communists or anti-NATO people or anti-European people or some strange people, strange from point of view European integration. But now it's already 1 year after the parliamentary elections we had in October 1st, 2012, and I believe there are no question marks about this, who this new government is and what we are going to do. We just want to become an integral part of Europe. We want to enter NATO because we believe that this is the right place for to be for a country like Georgia, which is seeking security umbrella and also is seeking to be friend of democratic community of countries. And we want to increase the speed of our integration in European structures, and we want to establish European standards in Georgia, because we Georgians, we are feeling ourselves as European as well, because during these 2 days we heard several times the expression of our Latvian friends that even during Soviet Union Latvians felt that this is their part of Europe rather than part of the empire where we are unfortunately for so long. That's the case for Georgians as well. And the Georgian civilization, which starts centuries ago, was always related to Europe and to the Christian world and to the things which were happening in Europe. I'm not going in history, of course. The history is important thing, but we are looking forward. Just I want to tell you that the European choice is not choice of Republican Party, which I represent, or Georgian Dream Party, which Mr. Japaridze represents, or Green Party, which Mr. Gachilade represents, or Free Democrats, which Mr. Dolidze represents. And of course, not only of the United National Movement, which Mr. Darceshvili represents. This is our very colorful delegation. The European choice is our common choice because it is the choice of Georgian people. And politicians, we try to serve to the best interests of the nation. And the European choice is expressed very well and very demonstratively, I would say, in everything possible. Is that opinion polls? We are around 80% of Georgians are in favor of Georgia's integration to European Union, Georgia's membership to NATO. The last elections demonstrated it once again, because at least 90% of votes were given to the political groups who are advocating for European integration, for NATO membership. Therefore, if there are any skeptics left who believe that, well, skeptics or optimists, depending from which side people are looking to the issue, that Georgia can change its foreign policy directions, they are wrong, because it's impossible to change that. It's not pragmatic. It's not based on the mood of the people or choice of the nation, and then so and so on. And in fact, we do not have any other choice, because we sometimes when we have this discussion, this question is posted. But if we say no to Europe, if we say no to NATO, then what? Then where we are and what is happening around? This is destiny. This is the this is positive destiny, and this is how it is. Therefore, if there are any optimists again, from the other point of view, who believe that something could happen in Georgia, that if not after these elections, after next elections, some leaders could win and they could turn this policy to different direction and to, I don't know, think about Eurasian custom union or some other security umbrellas and so on, well, it's this optimism of those people will never be true. And again, the latest developments demonstrated this. However, the integration process is not something which is guaranteed, which is already given fact, and we have just the signatures left to sign on papers. That's the key issue, and there we are concentrated. The new government is concentrated not about thinking where to go, but about thinking how to go and how to speed up this process. Because to become part of Europe, we need to have European standards already established in our country. Just promises that we will have this kind of environment for business, that kind of environment for political freedoms, or this kind of system of safety regulations, or that kind of system of border security and so on. Promises are not taken into account. We need to do our homework, and in that regard, that's why we are coming so frequently here and in other Baltic states, in Eastern European countries, who have gone through this process, who have already experienced how to do this, how to implement concrete policies in order to be ready for those challenges which Europe brings. Because we understand that European Union and becoming associate member and in future times even a member country, it imposes challenges as well, and we need to be ready for that on the policy level. That's why we are coming here for so frequently, and we promise to our colleagues that we will be bothering them in the future as well. We know now it is very a busy time for the parliament here. They are going to consider the budget, and we are taking valuable time with Ms. Speaker and other MPs. But I believe this is part of our job of parliamentarians, to think and to work about internal issues, but to think and to work on international issues, because we need to make our country stronger. And we have a lot of common problems, not only those 50 years which we spent in the Soviet Empire, but the current common issues and current common problems. It is not so easy to be a small country, to be in a difficult region surrounded by big players, and to be prosperous country, to be peaceful country, to be equal member of the international society. It's very difficult. It is very difficult for Georgia as well. You know, more than 20% of territories are occupied at the moment, and we are living with that constant threat. Well, when I'm opening news channels every day, or the news digest, well, my heart is starting beating faster, because I expect another news that another, I don't know, 100 meters of Georgian land has been bordered through the occupation line, and another that families were left without with access to their cemeteries and their land and so on. And that's our constant life. And we live under this kind of pressure. But we understand that the only way to solve our internal problems is to be reliable partners for the democratic world, and to be become the part of democratic world. And only through this diplomacy we can solve our problems with our northern neighbor. Because the option of war, option of more tanks than Russia can bring to Georgia, is not an option at all. And the only thing which keeps the country together at the moment is the help of the international community. And we are very thankful to our Latvian friends, who were always one of the first who were responding to these problems, who were making statements, who were active in international organizations for adopting the decisions which were just dictated from the common sense and from the best standards of the international law and the world system. And we want to continue this cooperation. At the same time, we want to offer something to our friends. It's economic cooperation. And we can find new ways how to make the business community connected to each other. This one seemingly small issue, the direct flight between Riga and Tbilisi, is a huge thing. It is already giving so much results when we see that the tourists during summertime are more coming from Latvia, and we are glad to have even more. When business community can interact to each other, when cultural exchanges could happen. Today we visited a wonderful museum which was restored just recently. And we spoke about the project possibility to bring Pirosmani here soon. And there is already this work started, and as soon as we come back to Tbilisi, we will do our best to make it happen and to see this more cultural exchange. I was glad to hear that this wonderful school have a special project for enabling Georgian students to come here and study. We'll be ready to host Latvian students if they find interesting to come to Georgia and study. One of the good things which the previous government achieved was to make attractive certain universities of Georgia to foreign students. And we have a lot of foreign students now coming from different countries, and we want to continue, of course, without looking to the origin of those students. Are they from friendly countries or unfriendly countries? We need to forget these kind of issues when talking about culture, sport, education, economy. Only in that case we can build the world we are dreaming about. That's why the new government initiated some small things with Russia. It's just opening a market for Georgian wine and mineral water. We understand that this is not the solution or the bigger problems. But at the same time, we believe that without such ties between the countries and societies, those big problems would be never solved. Because those problems are not going to be solved with, again, one signature or one tank or something like that. That's why we are eager to continue this policy. It is very difficult to be a Georgian and to go to Sochi Olympics, which is just, I don't know, 10, 20 kilometers from the Georgian border, which we cannot approach from any side. But we have this political vision. Of course, it's finally up to the Olympic Committee to make decision, but political vision, political decision of the government is to go there. It is very difficult, it is hard, but we still want to demonstrate that that's our goodwill, despite all the problems, despite this kind of, I would call provocation, nothing else, when the first carrier of the Olympic fire was a pilot of Russian military plane which bombed Georgian mosque during August 2008 war. Well, despite these kind of things, we want to be together with the international community. If the international community was ready to boycott the Olympics because of reasons of Georgia or others, well, we would be there as well. But we are a small country and we are a vulnerable country, and we need to be in line of European Union, European countries, US, if we want to survive in this very difficult journey. The things like human rights and democracy and rule of law and constitutional foundations of the country remain unfinished task in Georgia. And the new government wants to deal with that successfully as well. It is not as easy, again, taking into consideration the difficulties of the region. We want to have a free country where people can come easily and live easily, and the borders are not closed, because we want to have more tourists, more business community and so on. But at the same time, we need to remember that, for example, Syria is very close to Georgia. It's just Turkey which divides Georgia from Syria, and that hot region currently, not to mention other hot areas in the neighborhood of South Caucasus. Therefore, we need to be careful about that. The same could be said about breakaway regions, where we do not control the situation, and sometimes it is not very clear who controls situation there, if anybody controls the situation, especially in former South Ossetian region. Therefore, we need to be cautious about possible international terrorism, drug trafficking, human trafficking, and other issues, and this is another kind of headache in our reality. But at the same time, these concerns should not serve as some excuse for not allowing the basic human rights, basic freedoms of the people, including political freedoms. And then we want to increase this level and standard. There are some issues about minorities and minority religion. There was, for example, one case when about 2 months ago or 1.5 months ago, a minaret was taken out by authorities from one of the villages on the grounds of some unpaid customs duty of the when this construction crossed Georgian border and so on, which generated a lot of tensions locally. Well, we all understand when things come to religious feelings, everything becomes very sensitive. But I hope in these days the decision will be to put back this minaret in the place where it was. And the local council is considering that, and the central government is working on that. We have many issues like that. I'm just giving you some examples, not everything, not to overload you with the details, just to demonstrate that our European choice means to deal successfully with all these problems. Because we understand that many European countries and societies are a little bit concerned when thinking about countries like Georgia becoming part of European system. Because some have this concern that with that they may be importing some problems. And we don't want to concern citizens of Germany or Britain or France or whoever that if Georgia becomes, for example, NATO member, that means that tomorrow there will be war with Russia involving Europe. Of course, that's not our objective or that's not our thinking or something like that. And then we need to help to our European friends to find proper solutions, proper ways how to deal with this complex problem. But at the same time, we took it very seriously when it was declared in Bucharest that Georgia will become NATO member. It was said by all NATO member countries. And we took these words very seriously, and we remember it all the day. And we are not going to let you, NATO members, to forget those words as well. About the timing or about the process, how to do this, how to make it sure, there we are ready to discuss the issues, the speed of the integration process, the methods, the ways, in order to ensure that this is not one-way traffic only and Georgia benefits from something and the rest of the Europe or NATO member countries are putting themselves in problem. So these are the issues we touched during 2 days meetings with the Latvian leadership. We met with the Speaker of the Parliament, with the members of the Parliament, we met with the President of the country, with the Prime Minister, with the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and we are meeting now to you, with you, with students, with young people who are going to judge everything, how we are performing and how your government is performing, and probably this is equally important equation.
With this I am concluding my sort of accompanying remark,
I guess in between a bit, since I'm also the part of the organizing and the host, but we have also the expert.
Only 3 minutes, I will try. I'm not sure I will manage, but
I didn't say that. East European Policy Research Center. Andis, please, the floor is yours.